Welcome to the Digital Pathology Place. I'm Alexandra Zhurev, and if this is your first time here, please consider subscribing. Today's video is going to be about how to annotate an image scope. Image scope is a slide viewer available from Aperio Leica. You can download it now for free, and it's pretty easy to annotate slides in there, and I want to show you how to do it. So I'm going to share my screen with you. Here we are in the Aperio Image Scope. I'm gonna put the link for download in the video notes. Aperio Image Scope is a classic, meaning this is probably the first viewer for host light images. So if you are a computer scientist and you are designing a new viewer, please go ahead and check what it has so that you don't reinvent the wheel. Basically, everything that we want to use is located in the upper ribbon. And you probably noticed this arrow showing up. And normally, if you want to move the slide, you use this pan navigation, the hand, and you move the slide. But if you want to avoid dragging the hand up and down and clicking several times, you can just go up. This arrow appears, and you move up to the end of the slide by just pressing the mouse left button. Same counts for left and right. This is a very useful feature. If you're designing a slide viewer, please incorporate this feature. This is an adrenal gland of an opossum, and the circles here are parasitophorous vacuoles of Besnoitia species, an apicomplexan parasite, and we're gonna annotate a few of them. Our annotation tool is the pen tool, and you can see the shortcut as well. I'm gonna click on one, and I'm gonna annotate the parasitophorus vacuole, just a gross annotation, and you can see that it becomes green. When you want to see exactly what color and what class you're annotating, you click on the annotations window. It appears in the new window. So if you have two monitors, it's gonna be very handy. And you can see here that we annotated in layer one. We can change the name of this layer by double clicking on it or triple clicking by clicking. And I wanna call it vacuole. And I want to change the color to, let's take yellow. And when we exit this, we see that the color changed to yellow. And now we can annotate in yellow. And if we want to, we can add another class by clicking this plus button. And I want to just add a class called tissue. Vacuoles yellow tissue. I'm going to change the color. I'm going to change it to red. And just move it to the side. And I'm going to annotate the tissue. Just example annotations. The next pen here, pen with a little dotted line, is the negative pen tool, meaning you can make holes in your annotations. So if I want to make a hole here, this is this negative pen that I'm using, and then my annotation is only the outside ring of this donut. For example, here, if I wanted to exclude something, I do the negative annotation as well. And then my annotation is only the outside. We can use a ruler to measure things, but notice that I didn't change the class, and it's measuring something of the class tissue. I wanted to measure my vacuole, the little one. If I want to remove this one, I just press delete, and the window appears asking me if I really want to delete. Yes, I want to delete. The next one I want to delete as well. Let me switch the tool. I want to delete this one as well. Then we have rectangle,
and circle. I usually use the freehand tool for annotations for everything. So I don't really use the squares and circles. I imagine there can be some use cases for this. That's not my first priority feature in a slide image viewer or an annotation tool. The arrow, though, is a very nice tool if I want to point somewhere. And where you start clicking, the arrow head appears. So if I click on this artifact here, this is where my arrow head is going to be. And I'm going to delete them. If I want to delete everything from a class, I go back to my detailed view and I click on this cross delete layer. I'm going to delete my whole tissue layer. Yes, I want to delete, and that leaves me with just one layer of my vacuoles. I want to show you the next tool. The next tool is the cell counter, the counter tool, this hashtag here. I want to count these cells here. And you can see that it's still the same class. If I want to have it in a different class, those counters, I would have to add a new class because it makes the counters within my vacuole class. But my point here is that you just click on the structures that you're seeing and you want to count, and you don't have to worry about anything else because the counter is counting this for you. And you can see how many of the objects you have already counted and where are they located. You can change the view to vertical and horizontal. I don't see much use for that. And when you close this image, let us exit the full screen view. It's going to ask you if you want to save the annotations. And you just say yes. And those annotations are exported as an XML file and are stored together with the image. They are attached to the image. We do not modify the image. We just create a layer on top of this image. And if you want to share this file with your colleague to show, ask questions, you can just send this file in an email. And if your colleague has the same slide with the same number, this annotation will be automatically attached to that slide. Obviously, you can send both files together. But if you are working on the same data set, it's enough to send the annotation file. For now, I'm going to cancel. This tool has all the basic annotation functionalities and is a good place to start if you want to annotate whole slide images. You can send the annotations and import them on a different computer and use them for all the different purposes you want to use your annotations.
I hope it was useful and see you in the next video.